But first, people around the world have taken to the streets to demand change. We talked to a progressive thinker about the phenomenon.
Slavoj Žižek is a provocateur. He's called for cutting off the balls of capitalism in favor of a new social order. And he wants to provide the intellectual substance for the rising global protest movement. The time is ripe for a new beginning, he says. But what exactly does that mean?
Our societies are more and more returning to some kind of apartheid logic. There are people who are in, there are people who are out. All this slowly, slowly is, I think, approaching a kind of a zero point where the fundamental coordinates of our societies, freedoms and so on, are potentially threatened.
Getting rid of democracy, would that be a solution?
No, but democracy will have to be reinvented or it will simply become obsolete.
Our society needs to adopt some of the principles of communism, Žižek says. Natural resources, scientific research, and digital technology should not be a source of private profit. They should belong to everyone.
You're from Slovenia and experienced the stark reality of living under a socialist regime. For example, you are not allowed to teach. Isn't it difficult to believe in the idea of communism after all this?
You know, the Yugoslav socialism was something specific. It was a little bit better. Borders were completely open. We had access to all Western books. We nonetheless lived in a communist country. So we saw that communist system doesn't work. But at the same time, Western capitalism was for us not like for the people in DDR or in Bulgaria, I don't know where, a kind of a distant ideal.
So you were in between.
In between, and I think precisely that when you pass from one social order to another, this time of passage in between is the time where things for a moment become visible.
A time like 2011. Across the world, people took to the streets to protest social injustice and the excesses of capitalism. The Occupy movement has become a global phenomenon. And Slavoj Žižek has become one of its most prominent intellectual mentors.
We are the awakening from a dream which is turning into a nightmare.
You once said that the Occupy movement doesn't go far enough.
It's very easy to put the blame on greedy bankers. The task should not be to change people, but to change the system so that people will have less opportunities to realize, actualize their evil.
Do you still agree with this protest?
Yeah, but we should have no illusions. It's so easy to fall in love with you. Isn't it nice? We are all solidary here and so on. This doesn't fascinate me at all. I never like these big enthusiastic moments. What interests me is the day after.
Now all eyes are on the Arab world. What follows the Arab Spring? In Tunisia, Libya, and Egypt, popular uprisings toppled a dictator. But what will happen now?
Let's be clear. For example, in Egypt, the army is still the good old Mubarak army. It's a kind of a silent pact between the army and the Muslim Brotherhood, the Islamists, a kind of division of spheres.
So you don't believe in a real change in the Arab countries?
No. They can happen. The most promising event in Egypt in the last month was this incredible, how should I call it, fermenting life of reconstructing civil society, trade unions, women organizing themselves, students and so on. This is the only hope.
Slavoj Žižek is an intellectual skeptic. He knows how lofty ideals can be crushed under the wheels of realpolitik and how seductive capitalism can be. And he knows the risks of intellectual vanity.
you have turned into a kind of rock star of the leftist movement. What is it like to be put on a pedestal?
It's disgusting. I will tell you why. Because I think that this false celebration of me as a rock star is basically a refined and very effective way of getting rid of me. In the sense of, oh, he's an amusing guy, but don't take him too seriously. The new formula is now, he may appear to be just a clown, a stand-up comedian, but be careful. Beneath this appearance, there is a deadly, dangerous, violent message.
For Slavoj Žižek, the true message is to question everything.